sporadic. Crazy. Yeah, yeah. Like, he's not talking
about that. Evander Holyfield just retired last week. He did. What do you tell him about Holyfield, Tyson? What did everybody think?
Everybody thought that he was washed up.
Holyfield.
So far, yeah, Holyfield. So far away from being washed up, that's why he walked through him, because he wasn't afraid of him and might beat everybody before he stepped into the ring.
Mentally. He broke him down.
You know, he fought Alex Stewart. Alex Stewart had his children in the seats, his wife, and everybody was crying. You know, Evander Holyfield went in there with a positive attitude, with no fear, and he did what he had to do.
Beat him in the first one, then in the rematch.
But see, this is the same thing that Mayweather thinks about Pacquiao. And if he takes that fight, he's going to be in for a rude awakening.
Yes,
I'm telling you, because Pacquiao is not washed up.
All right, so who wins that fight? Who do you think? Mayweather or Pacquiao?
Pacquiao. I wouldn't doubt if it was a knockout. That's how far I would go, because I don't think that Floyd really is into mixing it up. And everybody seems to lean on working his body, but never going to the head. But if you go to the head, you work the body, then go to the head, you can take him out.
Statistically, Manny has not knocked out his last 8 opponents in the last 4 years.
Right.
You think next year, he's not going to get any younger. He might. Listen, he's a great boxer. He's a legend. He's one of the greatest of all time. No question.
But styles make fights. He's a counterpuncher. Floyd's a counterpuncher. Pacquiao's going to bring the fight to him. So that's a big difference between somebody moving forward and somebody moving backwards. Floyd likes to pick his poison. You can't pick your poison when you fight against somebody who's aggressive.
All right.
Right?
All right. I didn't know Russell Simmons knew so much about boxing.
Know a lot about boxing. I've been watching for like 40, 50 years.
I know. I could tell. I could tell.
Telling people which celeb, you know, hey.
That's what I do all day.
Talking to Tom. Like, you're just coming up with people.
Who did I get
Tom
last
Green
week?
Tom Green used to do that. Celebrity watching. He'd go up to people and be like, oh my God, I can't believe it's you. Russell Simmons, how you doing? It's so great to see you on the street in LA. I can't believe you're here.
Okay, who's the greatest fighter of all time? Greatest fighter of all time. The best ever.
Floyd
Mayweather?
Joe Louis.
Why Joe Louis?
Joe Louis was a, as in baseball, he would be considered a 5-2 player. He had speed, he had heart, he had stamina. And I love Muhammad Ali, but Joe Louis would have beat him, and if not, knocked him out. And I love Muhammad Ali. He transcended sports, you know, but Joe Louis was the best fighter of all time. And if the middleweight, you know, when you start talking
How did they do all that with cops right
there?
Right? You know what I mean? If I just make a left turn, they
and
jump on me.
But if you talk about going down to the lower division, Sugar Ray Robinson was the man.
So there you have it. Yeah. Stay tuned. What about Marciano, 49-0?
Marciano was good, but he wasn't great. You know, he fought Joe Louis when Joe Louis was washed up, but Joe Louis
would have
knocked him out.
And he cried. And he cried.
He didn't want to fight him. But Joe Louis would have knocked him out in his
Okay, prime. If they make a movie about a fighter, which fighter could Omar Miller play?
Omar Miller could play actually Joe Louis, but I would prefer to see him play. I would prefer to see him be Jack Johnson.
Jack Johnson? That would be a great movie. Did they pass that thing in Congress yet?
You know who I could be in a movie as a fighter? Oh. Ivan Drago. That would break you.
Either that, or if Conan ever gets in a fight with someone, like you know, Drake and Chris Brown wanted to get $9 million.
They do it.
They're friends now.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
I'm not up on
that. They squashed their little beef. But when you grow up in the richest neighborhood in Canada, it's easy to squash beefs, right? You just
No, he started from the bottom.
Mom and
Drake started from the bottom.
You know, you're Jewish. His mom's Jewish.
I know. White but he Jewish started from one. The bottom. Now he's here.
You didn't see that in the 1980s.
No fights are mediocre when you talk about the greats, man. Jack Johnson, how long did he fight? He fought a 30-round fight or something like that.
They were fighting 30 rounds last week.
He fought three fights a day with bare knuckle, right?
Yeah, come on, dude.
Bare knuckles.
He knocked somebody's teeth out with his fists. Come on.
You know, you hit a punching bag.
You hit a white fighter that's
You hit a punching bag for 30 minutes, and it felt like you were on the bag for 3 years.
You're right. Tommy Morrison was supposed to be that great white heavyweight, right? And he screwed
it
up.
Was that before Mike Tyson cracked the skull?
Yeah. Oh, Tommy Morrison.
Right?
He got AIDS, right?
To quote
Donald Sterling. That's got AIDS.
But that's not what brought him down, though. No. Tommy Morrison was
You know, he used to hit me up a lot on
Facebook. I just wanted to quote Donald Sterling. He's got AIDS. But Magic Johnson,
right?
Did you see that interview with Donald Sterling and... Actually, I mean, Anderson Cooper, when he talked to Anderson.
Nah, I don't like Anderson Cooper.
I thought you were going to say you don't like Donald Sterling. I don't like Donald Sterling.
I don't know the guy.
Anderson Cooper's good. He's the Clippers owner. He's a crazy,
that guy.
Clippers owner.
Later, all right, see you guys. We'll be in touch.
Nice meeting you.
For sure. FaceyReport.com, right back reporting.